Welcome back to Our Community. Susie Thomas visiting with Lisa Wood and Alicia Davidson from Child and Adolescent Behavioral Health, CNA for short. We also have a for short WHM, which is the Wholehearted Movement. Which one of you, would that be Lisa, to tell us more about this?
Yes. Well, Wholehearted Movement came out of after I was trauma trained at CNA. I became very clear on the idea that in order to help heal traumatized children, you needed to have a body-mind connection. There needed to be where the kiddos could get out of their heads back into their bodies, where they can access some of that trauma memory and express it in a way that's safe and but also complete. And so I got to thinking about, well, it's one thing to have them draw or paint, and that's all very good, but body is body, and I wanted to create a dance movement program where I could take them through a creative process that felt like just being in a high school play.
Mm-hmm.
So it didn't feel like therapy necessarily, but they went through all of these different phases of that experience where finally they perform at the very end, and that performance is their mental health story.
Mm.
Whether that's a trauma story or just they're wrestling with anxiety or depression, but they get to tell their story to music and movement in a complete way and then perform it themselves, or if they feel too much anxiety, which we don't want to add to, they would ask one of the other leaders to learn. They would teach their dance to one of the other leaders, and it would still be performed. So they still get to see their creation one way or the other performed.
Either as the dancer or as the choreographer.
Absolutely.
And they make up these steps themselves, and this acts out. What's the difference between dancing and then just doing charades of what happened to me?
Okay, well, we start them in the very beginning in the group part of the dance movement, where we will give them each week a phrase that might say, I watched the sun come up over the mountain. And then we ask them and show them different ways that they can take a simple phrase and turn it into a body movement. So from the very beginning, they're taking simple emotional sentences and translating them into movement. So by the time that they get back to their actual story that they're writing in their journals, they now can take sentence by sentence and begin to formulate their own movements.
Mm-hmm.
Based on their story.
And we would hope that all these stories end with a happy ending, but some of them might be in the middle of their story. So how does this work? What have you observed?
Well, that's exactly right. When we have them journal, we tell them there's a beginning, a middle, and an end to their story, and they will be in some portion of that. And so we recognize they may not be at the end, but that they are the authors of their own stories. So they rewrite or reauthor their story to be whatever they want it to be, regardless of what stage they're actually in.
You're really onto something, because I don't know if you're a Dancing with the Stars fan, but
so many
times they have like a week where they do this, where they go through a rough time in their life and they choreograph the dance to mean that. And each of those people that do this say how healing that was.
Mm-hmm.
What do you hear from the students? I'm hoping that you hear the same kind of thing.
Well, yeah, I actually, I can give you one kiddo has come back for this particular session in a leadership role because she completed it the last session, and it made such a difference in her life that she took that same dance and performed it at her church, she
Wow.
told me. So I brought her in this session as a leader so that she can begin to help some of the other kids and kind of pay forward how she went through this experience, and it felt empowering for her. And she laughs about how she can speak up to teachers now and do all sorts of things she couldn't do before. So getting in front of an audience and performing, I think the kiddos feel, if I can do that, I can do anything.
Anything. Mm-hmm. Yes, that's a pretty scary time. Anybody who's done a piano recital ever so can relate. You both, Alicia and Lisa, have something big coming up on January 28th. So everybody stop what you're doing, grab your phone, and mark January 28th because there's all kinds of things happening. Alicia, you go first. What's happening?
January the 28th is our biggest fundraiser of the year. It is our Let Your Light Shine fundraiser. And again, that'll be held on January the 28th at Brookside Country Club. It is going to be an event with casino-style gaming. If you guys like to gamble, it's definitely just for charity, of course. But, it's something that has kind of been unique to our fundraiser. We also will have a silent and a live auction as well. There's a lot of opportunities to have a good time and to support our agency and help us continue to provide these programs and services to the community.
Mm-hmm. Where'd you get the theme? Let Your Light Shine. I love that.
It was actually an idea that came from one of our board members. They liked the idea. It actually started with a little light bulb, and to kind of represent that each child has their own light to kind of shine bright, and we're trying to help our clients and the children in the community recognize that each of them has a light to that needs to be brought out. So it actually started with some light bulbs and kind of went from there. So it all started from our board.
I love it. And being in January, you are kind of kicking off dinner auction season around here.
We are. We absolutely are. We found that, coming off of the holidays, it's a nice way to kind of, do something that's obviously a big, tremendous help to the community and also just a way to kind of, start the new year off right, just have a good time and helping people. What more can you ask?
Do you have... it's kind of maybe early to ask. Any ideas of what some of the items are for auction that might entice us?
Yes, absolutely.
Oh, good.
For our live auction, we're going to have a week stay at a condo at Myrtle Beach.
Ooh. January, you'll have no trouble auctioning that off.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. We also are putting together an entertainment package as well from a local band, Frickin' Frack, has graciously donated their services. So we're going to be putting together an entertainment package around that.
How fun.
Some of our silent auction items, we have tickets to Disney World, tickets to Disney World.
That's a silent?
Yes,
wow.
That's a silent auction.
Wow.
So, yeah,
okay.
That just tells you just, how hard we're working to make sure we have some good items that reach out to just about everybody. We have a Coach purse as well. So something for, men. We'll also have some Cleveland Indians tickets. So it's something for everybody. We're trying to make sure that, there's something there that everybody would find some value in.
Ooh, and they are going to win the World Series. They're winning it all in 17.
You're calling it. You're the first to say it.
From my lips to God's ears.
I know.
But earlier that day, we've got a dance movement day, so the dinner auction will be a celebration of what we've just seen earlier. Lisa, what's happening?
Well, that's the day we received a beautiful grant from the Women's Endowment grant from Stark Community Foundation, and they are really interested in knowing when the day was that the kids would be dancing so that they could attend. So it has been set for January 28th as well, but it will be at noon. And it's in the Shipley Gym downtown at our CNA office.
And what kinds of things will we see there?
Oh, it's going to be exciting. Each kiddo, of course, will hopefully do some version of their dance. The first dance will be kind of an open creative thing that I'm going to have the kids do that they're not even really sure what they're going to do yet. So it's going to be a little bit of a visual as well as a movement-based creation. And then in the middle, we'll actually have one song that will be done where myself and my sister and my two brothers are going to be playing. So there's going to be a live song, and my kiddos will be dancing to that.
Oh my goodness!
And then the final, and then the kids, a couple of the other kiddos will do their dances, and then at the very end, we have another group dance that the kids will be doing. So.
Okay, and this is a happening, folks, because explain who your siblings are.
well, I have a brother, his name is Michael Jackson. And
but not that one yet.
Yeah, he's a... been a musician for as long as I can remember. He'll be doing the guitar parts for a song. And my sister Nancy is a jazz vocalist and singer in Asheville, North Carolina, and she will be singing the song with me that the kids will perform too.
And they are so good. Yeah. They are so good. That is reason enough to go.
And then my brother-in-law, my sister's husband, mm-hmm. is going to play an upright bass for the song. So it should be a really interesting arrangement, we hope.
And that again is January 20th. What day of the week is January 28th?
It's a Saturday.
Oh, great. All right. So you don't have work. There's no excuse. Is there a cost to come see the dance?
Oh, no. The dance movement itself, that performance is open. I'm not sure exactly how it's going to work yet in terms of the public. As you know, we have a lot of HIPAA violation mm-hmm. issues to be working
right.
around. So we're trying to figure that all out right now.
So we can't all come.
Maybe, maybe not. We have to figure that out. It'll really depend on the families themselves and whether they feel safe with large masses of people attending.
So stay tuned.
Stay tuned, exactly.
But what a wonderful day for the kids mm-hmm. and for their families to be able to just celebrate that. And then I'm sure public is invited to let your light shine.
Yes, the more the merrier.
What's the cost for that, Alicia?
The cost is $75 per person. You know, you get a meal, a dessert, and just a great time. So, you guys can call mm-hmm. Our downtown office, and if you guys have any questions at all, you can feel free to ask for myself, and I'd be happy to, you know, get the information to you so that you can come.
What's that number?
That number is 330-454-7917, and you can ask for myself, Alicia Davidson.
We always give it twice. Go ahead, because people just grabbed a pencil.
Absolutely. Okay. Again, that number is 330-454-7917.
Great. And ask for Alicia. Yes. All right. In our closing minutes, you also mentioned that there is an alternative school. Just hearing briefly about it, it almost sounds like foster care except for school rather than the family, that students are pulled temporarily from their home school, go to the alternative school, and then the goal being to get them back into their home school. That is a terrible explanation. Now I'll let Alicia do it.
Well, it's not that bad. you pretty much hit the nail on the head. We work very closely with Canton City Schools schools all over Stark County, also in Plain Township or Plain Local. If a teacher witnesses a student being disruptive in class, usually that teacher will let the principal know that they've noticed some issues. So the principal usually we actually have a lot of our school-based therapists actually in the schools. So a lot of times the teacher or principal will reach out to that therapist in the school, let them know what kind of issues they're having. If they believe at that point that they may do some good being removed from the school to develop some coping skills for whatever's mm-hmm. going on in their lives, they'll be sent to our trauma-informed day treatment school, which is at our Shipley location. We have behavioral interventionists in the class. We have counselors in the class as well as teachers. So we try to make sure that we are meeting all their needs educationally and emotionally in the classroom so that they are able to be transferred back to their home schools. So we're always looking for school supplies for our teachers, games to kind of work with them. We also have a kitchen upstairs. So, you know, we try to cook, you know, give them cooking activities so they can work as a team. So we're always looking for anything that will help these children get back to their home schools.
Great, great idea. Website where people can get more information.
Yes, that is www.childandadolescent.org.
Got it. Lisa Wood, Alicia Davidson, thank you so much for all you're doing in our community.
Thank you.
Thank you.